I had such great content yesterday, I filmed myself doing laundry. Things are only going uphill from here. And if you watched yesterday's video, you saw that I decided to name my vlog The Daily Trev, and that's now reflected on all my YouTube titles and YouTube thumbnails. Almost immediately after I switched everything over, I set up a domain, thedailytrev.com, that then forwards to the YouTube playlist where people can see all the videos. Pretty much after I did all this, I started immediately feeling self-conscious about it. And I even imagined like people being dicks about it and perhaps even going as far as laughing at me in my face. So I got kind of self-conscious about it and I thought, oh, maybe this is like kind of stupid. But the reality is that I think it's probably a pretty low likelihood that somebody would actually be mean to me about it. And if they did, does that really reflect on me or is that more reflecting on them? So I don't think that's really something that I have to worry about, but I guess we'll find out. But I'm pretty sure I'm probably not the only one that would be self-conscious about doing a vlog. When you're doing a vlog like this, it feels like I'm really putting myself out there and opening myself up to criticism and rejection and stuff like that. And those are thoughts that I either have to fight off or ignore or replace with something better. So I'm curious if anybody else has done something like this or if that is the main reason you would never do something like this. I've had multiple people now that I've talked to said, oh, I could never do that. So that's actually the main thing that I've been getting from other people when I talk to them about it. So I'm curious, could you see yourself ever doing something like this? In yesterday's Daily Trev, I did a screencast where I recorded my computer screen while I was making a new YouTube thumbnail for my YouTube channel. And I was a little bit concerned, and I am concerned, that doing this screencast with an application called Camtasia would add significantly to my editing time today. So I'm about to find out. There's a couple sections of that screencast that I think I'll want to either cut out, speed up, or shorten somehow just to make it so that it's more precise and doesn't go on and on. So I'm a little concerned about how much that'll add to my recording time today, or not my recording time, my editing time today, and I'm about to find out. I just finished editing the sequence where I recorded my screen and did a Canva tutorial on making YouTube thumbnails, and it didn't take me that long to edit it, surprisingly. I didn't keep a real good track of time, but it didn't feel like it took that long, at least. I definitely learned a few things that I think will help me the next time I do it to do it faster. There was multiple parts of the tutorial where it would have just been really boring to watch it at 1x playback speed, so I increased the playback speed by anywhere from 2 to 4 times on different parts of it so that it was a little bit smoother and wasn't boring to watch. And I think it'll be easier the next time I do it. There's a community in Edmonton called Summerside that a lot of people are crazy about. And that's because it has something called Lake Summerside, which is basically the community's own private beach that residents can use during the summer. And they've got a bunch of different events there. They've got a clubhouse as well as parks and whatnot. But the main draw is the actual lake, the beach, because there's a beach that people can go to and it's just for residents. But one thing a lot of people don't know or ends up becoming a problem is not all the homes in Summerside actually have lake access. There's a border for the Lake Summerside area of Summerside that allows people that live in that area to get lake access. But if you're outside that border, you don't get lake access. So that's actually an issue that's coming up right now with a client I'm working with. And we're having to take a look to see which properties have lake access and which ones don't. So if you are looking in that area, make sure you confirm whether or not the property has lake access. That's one of the main draws to that community, and it would be a very disappointing situation if you bought a property thinking you had lake access, but you actually didn't. So apparently a dress shirt looks really stupid when you're wearing shorts, or at least the pair of shorts that I put on with my dress shirt. So when I went out to go do some showings this afternoon, I got my girlfriend Norma's opinion because I didn't really think what I was wearing looked very good. And sure enough, it was borderline embarrassingly bad. So I had to change my shirt. I'm no longer wearing a dress shirt so that I don't look completely ridiculous out showing. I'm sure there's gotta be a way to make a dress shirt work with certain shorts, but if there is, I have not figured it out yet, and it's way too hot to wear anything but shorts right now. So back to a plain t-shirt it is.